Hi students, coming to the next topic in the subject microprocessor is we are discussing about the microcontroller, that is the 8051 microcontroller. Now let us see the addressing modes that are present in 8051 microcontroller. 8051 microcontroller provides a total of 5 addressing modes. So there are total 5 addressing modes that are present in that we used in 8051 microcontroller. The way in which the instruction is specified, whatever the instruction that we are writing in assembly language code, that can be specified by using 5 addressing modes: immediate, direct, register, register indirect, indexed. So only the 5 addressing modes. Now let us see each addressing modes clearly. The first one is the immediate addressing mode. So it's just like an 8086 microprocessor and 8085 microprocessor. A slight modification will be there. Let's see that. Immediate addressing mode. In this addressing mode, the source operand is constant. So it's just like whatever the source operand that is there, that is the value we are giving, that is the immediate data we are giving. So the source operand is a constant, means it's just a value. Immediate data must be preceded with a sign hash. So we already, so move a comma some hash 25. Hash means it's nothing but an immediate data. 25 is a constant, the value. Okay. So this addressing mode can be used to load information into any of the registers. So just it is used to load the data into any of the register. So let's see the example of immediate data. Move a comma hash 25 h. So here the 25 is nothing but it is a constant, or it's a value, that it is immediate value. That value is load into A register. Load 25H into A. Here also, load the decimal value 62 into R4 register. And here this is the, in this location, a value will be there that will be moved to this data pointer. Okay, so this is a immediate constant will be moved to data pointer. So that is about the immediate addressing mode. The only thing you have to be remembered that the immediate data should be, is followed with hash. Now coming to the direct addressing mode. In 8051, the direct addressing mode, here there are 128 bytes of RAM in 8051. So we already know 8051 will use 128 on-chip RAM. On-chip RAM will be present. So this mode most often used to access RAM location of from 32 7FH. So the location of RAM starts from 32 7FH. So these are the instructions how you are writing this direct addressing mode. Move R0 comma 40H. So if you mention hash here, it becomes a immediate data, but here we are not mentioning hash. So the save the content of RAM location to 40H in R0. So whatever the in 40H location, suppose here the 40 location is there. In that some content will be there. That will be moved to R0 register. Move R0 comma 40H means save content of RAM location 40H in R0. Move 56H comma A. Here save the content of A in RAM location. So these represents the RAM locations. It represents the RAM locations in 8051 microcontroller. When you are discussing about the direct addressing mode, so this address is present in the RAM location. A temporary data is stored in RAM location. So that is the data memory. You call it as a data memory, not the program memory. So the data memory or in the 40H, so there is some data that should be moved to R0. So A is a value that value has to be moved to RAM location 56H. So it's same as move A comma R4 is just, these both are the same. Instead of A comma 4, you write A comma R4, both are the same, which means copy the R4 into A, and this should be invalid. Okay, because you didn't mention the location here, the RAM location you have to be mentioned here. So you didn't mention the location, either you have to write the accumulator or you have to write one of the register. So this is that about the direct addressing mode. Now coming to the register addressing mode, the third addressing mode that is present in 805, that we use in 8051 microcontroller is register addressing mode. The register addressing mode involves the use of registers to hold the data to be manipulated. So the main concept here is we use only the registers. not the immediate data, not the direct addressing. Just we will use only the both side, the source and the destination both should be registers only. Move A, RI. Here the copy the content of RI into A register. And move RI, A. Same, the copy the contents of A. Contents means the values of A into RI register. So here the I value is from 0 to 7, which indicates the registers R0, R1 up to R7. So whatever the register if you want, you can take. Add A, RI means the values that are present in these registers will be added and the result will be stored in accumulator. Add the content of RI to contents of A. Okay. And save accumulator in RI. So this is about the different ways of representing the register addressing modes. And this is not possible here. So you can't move the value accumulator into directly to the DPTR. And this RM and RN are not the registers. So the registers in the special function registers that are present in 8051 microcontroller is from, you can take R0 to R7, A, B, program counter, DPTR. So these are all the only special function registers that you can use in 8051 microcontroller. RM and RN are not the registers. Okay. So this is about the register addressing mode. And the next register is addressing mode is register indirect addressing modes. Means just like 8086 and 8085 microcontroller, microprocessor, here also in that particular memory location a data will be there, that data has to be moved to this another register. So in this mode, register is used as a pointer to the data. So this you have to be remembered. Register indirect means pointer to the data. If data is inside the CPU, only registers R0 and R1 are used for this purpose. Okay, so here we will use only R0 and R1. Move A, content of RI. Here the RI should be I is equal to 1 or 1, 0 or 1. Move contents of RAM location whose address is held by RI in A, where address is held by RI into A. So just we are moving the content into A register. In the same way, B to RI. In other words, the content of registers R0 or R1 is source or a target in move, addition, subtraction with borrow instructions. So in those instructions also, opcodes also, we will use the content of registers R0 or R1. So you have to remember that register indirect addressing mode will use only two registers R0 and R1. And the last addressing mode that is used in 8051 microcontroller is indexed addressing mode. This mode is used in accessing data elements of lookup table entries located in program code ROM. So this up so far we have discussed about the RAM, whereas indexed addressing mode, here this mode is used in accessing data elements of lookup table entries located in program code ROM at 8051 microcontroller. So the equation for this is this. Move C, A, at the rate of A plus DPTR. Here A you call it as a content of address. A plus DPTR from ROM. So A plus DPTR is the content of location that is present in the ROM that should be moved to A. So here the C represents the program code. See, whenever move C is there, it's nothing but we are talking about the ROM. The data that is present in the ROM, we are reading that data. We are moving that data into one of the accumulator, one of the registers. So, because the data elements are stored in program code, ROM of 8051, it uses the instruction move C instead of move. So, here C means code. So this is about the different types of addressing modes that are used in the 8051 microcontroller. So totally there are 5 addressing modes. Immediate addressing mode, direct addressing mode, register addressing mode, register indirect addressing mode, indexed addressing mode. Thank you.